Yeah, we've talked a bunch about Travis Shaw, Zach Rice, Andre Green, George Pettaway for good reason. But there are guys later on this list, like Justin Kanyuk, who I'm still trying to figure out exactly how to spell it. Let me say it. Offensive lineman from Pennsylvania. I think UNC got a steal. He's a mid three-star guy, but has some good potential and could actually end up being a good center for North Carolina. That's what they're hoping that he turns out to. Deuce Caldwell, he doesn't have the measurables. And Clemson loved this kid, but decided to go in a different direction, did not offer him. But I mean, he was a guy that I think is just a player, and just didn't have, the size and the speed that you typically want, but just makes plays. You mentioned Connor Harrell, a kid who led the top team in the state of Alabama to back-to-back state championships. A loaded team, but still he was the quarterback of that team. Bryson Jennings, I feel like, is super underrated. I mean, he's a high three-star guy, but I mean, to me, if he would have got out there and people would have seen him in person, he looks like an NFL defensive end. He really does. And just moves so well, so smart. Another coach's son, Bo Atkinson, another kid, and we talked about him a bunch of prior podcasts, of just how he basically formed himself into an unbelievable edge rusher, through work and taking advantage of COVID. Marcus Allen. I mean, I know I'm just looking at these guys and I'm like, man, I need to really mention these guys because it's just, Marcus Allen, it could be a huge steal and he's not going to make any of my, I get asked, I'm going to get asked for some of your superlatives, just, who's a sleeper, who's the underrated guy, all that sort of stuff. And he's not a guy I'm going to mention just because there's other guys who are ranked lower and he's a four-star guy on 24/7 Sports, but he might end up being just unbelievable player and turning out to be like a high draft pick for North Carolina just because he has the experience, he has the coaching, he has the size, he's a legit 6'2" and he's long. So I mean, Malachi Hamrick, who I think is going to need to add some weight, but super explosive. I was just at a state championship game on Saturday. You mentioned it. Just unbelievably explosive. He played against a run first team, but still was able to get a sack. Tyon Holloway, another guy who I feel like is underrated, even though he's a four-star guy, who another guy who could potentially develop into a high draft pick just because of his tools. And he's a guy who just didn't want to mess with the whole recruiting process. And I think that benefited North Carolina with as far as recruiting him because he basically shut it down, didn't want to deal with it, found his place. But I think other schools really, if they would have laid their eyes on him, got to see him in camp settings and that sort of thing, that he would have blown up. So it's just up and down. I mean, I know I'm not mentioning everybody. It's not that I don't feel that they're good players. It's just really up and down. This is a really good class.